2023. Let's start the year off talking about something we all wish we had more of, finger technique. Unless you're Martin Frost, of course, in which case you put your excess finger technique up for auction on eBay. Now, if you plugged finger technique into your GPS, it would probably take you through the sprawling suburb of Closet. Maybe you'll visit the slightly odd town with lots of croissant bakeries called Jean-Jean or the extremely depressing village of Oule. But no matter what, every road goes through the megalopolis of Behrman. Rent a room, you'll be there a while. But even people from Behrman need to get out of town every so often, and many visit the lovely seaside town of Rose, and that is where we're going to be setting up shop today, number 8 on Rose 32 Street. We could talk about a lot of things with number 8. We could talk about Airstream. Let's do that for a second. It's simple. Play with a constant Airstream all the time. Write the word air in your part all over the place. Circle that word air. Why? Because air is what greases the skids for your fingers to move. Why? Because if you aren't pushing air through your instrument, you're holding it inside you. And if you hold air inside you, you get tense. And if you're tense, your fingers don't work well. And if your fingers don't work well, you get the point. Breathe through the instrument. We could also talk about articulation. This will take a few more seconds to discuss. For fast articulated music like this etude, you don't want to hit the reed hard with your tongue on each of the staccato notes. Let me explain. Let's imagine a pond of water. There's a breeze which causes little ripples in that pond. Nothing massive, nothing big, but you can see little vibrations on the surface. Think of your reed as that surface, with your air creating those vibrations. Now, imagine you're on the side of the pond and you pick up a stone that you're going to skip across the pond. You don't want to disrupt the ripples on the water. You just want to skip the stone along the surface. Your tongue is the stone in this part of the analogy. Now, if you toss the stone with enough velocity and at the right angle, it'll skip quickly, creating its own ripples, but it won't disrupt the ripples in the whole pond, right? Velocity is your airstream in this part of the analogy. Now, if you stop the reed with your tongue like this, it's like chucking the stone straight into the water. It disrupts the ripples and causes big ones in its place. Imagine what slamming your tongue into the reed does to its vibrations. No wonder it's hard to play fast articulated music. When you stop tongue, the reed has to start vibrating all over again. It's a totally inefficient way to use the piece of bamboo that generates all the sound your instrument makes. Give it a break, tongue lightly. Your reed, your audience, and I will thank you. Okay, you say, I thought you said this video was about finger technique. It is. Calm down. In order to have fast finger technique, though, you need to get those other things out of the way first. Okay, now, here's what you're looking at when you face down number 8. It's a lot of ink on the page. 16th notes all over the place. No organization to speak of, no dynamics or articulations other than those little staccatos. So the first thing we need to do is organize it into smaller, bite-sized chunks. Do we do this arbitrarily? No. Because if you look closely, the music shows us how it's organized. Measures 1 through 4 are one pattern, then 5 and 6 are another pattern. 7 is another, and 8 is yet another. Then 9 through 12, and 13 and 14. 17 through 21 is a hot mess, but basically an upper-lower neighbor vibe. 22 is doing its own thing, and then 23 and 24 are yet another pattern. 25 through 28 is yet another pattern, and 29 and 30 wrap it all up. And that's basically the first half, more or less. Now, what we do with this information makes all the difference in our finger techniques. I want you to draw a circle around the first note that starts each of these patterns we just looked at, and put a big tenuto over it. This will be your signal to hold that note a little longer than the others around it. Think of it as a brain rest stop. Collect your wits, and then move on. Without organizing the music and playing it the way we've just organized it, the music has no shape, and therefore it's just a mad dash for your brain to make sense of it. You're basically holding on for dear life, hoping that your fingers don't slip up. Here, listen. Now, playing it the way we've organized it, it not only helps us stay sane, it helps our fingers by helping our brain break up the massive notes into smaller phrases. It also sounds better. Here, listen to that. Practice your music this way from the start. When you first start a new technically challenging etude or piece of music, don't just sit down and start hacking away at it. Look at it. Make some notes about where phrases seem to start and end. Try to play it through in your head, and then make some more notes. And then, and only then, should you get your instrument out and metronome out and start playing through it slowly. Pause briefly on any of those transitional notes. Make changes if it sounds weird. It probably won't though, and move on from there. Organizing your music helps you practice more efficiently. It gets more done in less time. Okay? Okay. Thanks for watching. Let me hear from you if you've got any technique tips that you'd like to share, and we will see you next time. Take care.